disadvantage, advantage, and for some reason they always give that to the younger guy. I'm not sure where that came from. Look, Jim, tell me this. When you were a senior in high school in 18, how many fifth graders were you scared of? I don't know at what point in life we decide that the younger guy has the advantage, but I will acknowledge that tonight, Randall is a little more youthful.
Let's get this thing on the road. Let's go up to Dean Stone.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the BOK Center, Tulsa, Oklahoma, Battlegrounds MMA presents our second quarterfinal tournament match scheduled for three rounds. Your referee in charge of the action, Kevin Nix. Introducing first, in our blue corner, standing 5 feet 10 inches tall, official weight 170.5 pounds, professional record 11 victories, 3 defeats. Ladies and gentlemen, he represents the Last Stand Fight Team from Oakdale, California, presenting Randall Buddy Wallace. His opponent across the cage in our red corner stands at 5 feet 11 inches tall. Official weight an even 170 pounds. Professional record 16 victories, 9 defeats. He represents the American Top Team Atlanta. Ladies and gentlemen, from Atlanta, Georgia, by way of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, presenting Roan Carneiro.
Well, the big dude against Buddy.
Again, our referee in charge, Kevin Nix, for the final instructions.
I got it expected. No fouls, touch gloves, be warriors.
You know, the irony here is that the big dude hasn't fought in over a year, and Buddy fought 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, that is ironic. He ran over to Mexico. He got himself a TKO win. Now, let's not forget, guys, we're in a tournament. This is the second quarterfinal round. The first round was, of course, just won by Trey Houston. The winner of this fight will compete with Trey Houston. So Trey's in the back right now. He's studying this. And more than anything, Jim, I can assure you, he's not cheering for an outcome. He's cheering for a long, drawn-out contest. And so far, Honan's a little bit reserved. I expected him to come out a little bit quicker. So what he promised us he was going to do is try to get his opponent to the mat and get him out of here. So far, he's coming out and he's being a little bit patient.
That's the maturity, the experience of Honan. Originally from Brazil, says he loves living in Atlanta, loves training, but he's here to win $50,000.
There's a good shot. He's mixing it up very well, Jim. He got this takedown, but don't think he just changed elevation and shot. He threw a good three-beat combo first. He got Buddy to pick his hands up, and that's when Honan was able to come underneath. This is not where you want to be. Oh, Honan transitions to a full mount. He's got a cage on one side. That cage is said to be like a fifth body part or a third arm, if you will. It makes it very difficult to move. And right now, Randy Buddy Wallace is stuck.
Buddy doesn't want to find himself here in no man's land against this veteran very long. But, you know, it's amazing to get a young kid like Buddy. You know, Buddy's 25. He teaches every day. He's not going to make a lot of mistakes. And Buddy's got to take advantage of something. Obviously, I guess what I'm saying is that Buddy, as much as we liked him in our fighters meeting, is a decided underdog in this fight.
Yeah, he certainly is. He works his way back up to the cage here. I talked about the fence being the third arm. That goes both ways. That's for the offensive guy, but it's also defensively. In this case, Buddy just used it to his advantage. Honan's got his arms locked. He wants to drag him back to the mat. But as Buddy starts to sink his hips out, this position is going to change. Honan being very reserved, using the fence there. Almost Anthony Pettis style, except for a grappling advantage. And Honan's got his back.
Thank you for thanking a rear naked choke, perhaps, by Honan.
Of everything Honan does well, this is his biggest strength. When he fails at the rear naked choke, he swings immediately into an armbar. He's looking for the choke now. He secured what's called a body triangle. That's going to make it very difficult for his opponent, Buddy, to slip out of this. Gives him a little bit of time. He can do two things here. He can use some strikes, but he can also sink in the rear naked choke. He's starting to look for the armbar, Jim. And he's going to find it. He's got the arm bar. If he can break the grasp of Buddy, this fight's going to be all over.
Buddy trying to protect his right arm in a precarious position. And a hammer fist right in the face. Buddy is gallant. He is fighting. You see the passion.
Right now, all they're fighting for is the lock. Whoever controls the lock wins. If Buddy can keep his hands locked, he'll survive. And right here, Honan is able to extend, and that arm is extending. We're seeing Buddy show tremendous heart here. Honan is going to have to adjust with him if he wants to find this submission. And there's the tap. I hope the ref saw it, and he did.
The big dude made Buddy tap out with 1:30 left in the first round. And we stress first round because this is a tournament. And the veteran will advance.
Hohen was very patient. He was very controlled out there, Jim. That was the opposite of what he told us. He told us he was going to get out there, be aggressive, and look for the finish. He did all of those things minus the aggression. However, it's a tournament. It's about one thing, and that is advancement. He will advance to the semifinals to take on Trey Houston. Now, let's take a look at this setup. And the reason I really want you to see this, Jim, is we may see this again tonight. This is Honan's specialty. He starts with a rear naked choke. If you defend the rear naked choke, he swings right into an arm bar. The reason I was able to predict this before this happened is because Brian Stan, his training partner, told me that this is his bread and butter. Right here, they're fighting over a lock. Whoever controls the lock wins the fight. Honan able to separate Buddy's hands. We've got a big finish right here. Buddy's on the referee's on the far side. I was worried he didn't see this and that Buddy was going to leave with only one arm tonight, but he leaves in one piece, and there's your winner.
Only the second armbar win in the career of the big dude there. And we saw Buddy with a lot of guts as we take it up to Dean Stone.
Ladies and gentlemen, the official time, 3 minutes and 29 seconds of round number one. Your winner by tap out submission due to an armbar, Hohen Jukal Carneiro.
Well, we know now our first semifinal matchup that we will see later here tonight.